we're going to do here is show you how to lace up the Steenbeck machine. And what we're looking for, before any of this material is transferred, are making sure that the material is in a fit state to be transferred, if there are any problems, if the sink is out. And I'll show you some of the operation of how we lace the film up and the various things that we do when we're running the film. We've got aspect ratio we can change if we've got widescreen films or normal ratio. We've got a time code setting if we want to have a VHS copy made with a time code. We can run the picture separately. This is a picture head, and this is a sound head, a mag head, and we can run the mag separately. So we can run them together or individually, stop one and then run the other. And the button here will be for racking the film. Right, we're going to lace up the film now. I'll start off with the picture material. What you have to be very careful is that you're actually going around the correct rollers, because if you don't, you can end up scratching the film. And one of the common mistakes that is made is that you can run the film through one of the hard edges, say of the mag pickup here, and end up seriously scratching the material. So what I've got here is running it through the separate picture head. You could run here if you had a combined print, but we're actually going to be running a separate picture. So I'm going through the rollers. Right, I'm now going to lace up the mag track. So the first thing I'm going to do is make sure that the picture is switched off, so that when I run the machine, the picture won't run forward. And then when lacing up the mag, we have to make sure that the tension is nice and taut, otherwise you'll get distortion to the sound. I'll just pull the perforation through, and here you can see where the actual mag head is, that it's nice and tight. You've got the rollers here that'll take up the tension. I mean, you don't want it too tight, that you're actually going to be almost stretching the film, but if it's too loose, then you'll be getting a sort of a wow and a distortion here. So I'll just gently ease the film through onto the film bobbin, pushing it through and taking it up, and there you go. Now, some people maybe who aren't that experienced with lacing films onto bobbins will use tape. Not a good idea. If you put tape on the bobbin and then when the film has been run and then wound backwards, it can actually be quite tight and sometimes snap the film even. So don't use tape. You can push it through the little areas that are cut in the bobbin or core, but I mean, you should actually get used to doing. I'll just show you what I did again. Just place it round, let it go through gently, got my thumb against the core, and there it is. Right, the next thing I'm going to do is get the picture and the soundtrack in sync. So I'm going to be looking for the sync marks. So I'm now going to turn the picture on so it'll run with the mag, run it through, and then I'm going to be looking for the sync marks. The other thing also is to check that it's in rack. Now, this button here will do the rack, and if you look on the screen, you'll see that the picture is rolling. Now it's in rack, so I'll leave it in the correct position. And here comes the sync mark. You can actually ease them through if you wish by hand, and I'll do that when I get to the mag track. So I'm going to lock off the picture. There I have the sync mark for the picture. And I'm going to run the mag track until I get the sync mark for the mag. Just watching out for it. It's just coming through here. So there's the cross for the sync mark. I'm going to stop it on the mag head. You can actually also, by doing that, ease it backward and forward until you get the exact position. So I've got the sync mark on the mag head. Lock it off. Sync mark for the picture. And I'll lock that off. So now the mag and the picture will run together in sync.
in the BBC Night programme, with the exception of the triple broadcast of the 1500 metres.
We've previously looked at a separate picture and a separate mag track. Now we're going to look at a combined print, which is sometimes called a com-op. So I shall lace it up. And what we have, we lace up the picture. And then I'm going to go through the sound head. And we go through a sprocket drive here because it keeps the film nice and taut. If we didn't go through this one here, you can get some distortion on the sound. And then here we have the exciter lamp, which plays on the soundtrack of the film. So our soundtrack is actually running through the sound head here.
New Year in again on its first night. That's because for 2 years past, New Year's Eve has coincided with the weekend. And that's probably why this year's affair was bigger and better than ever before. The fancy dress theme was hunting, shooting and fishing. And it seemed that half the country was there. Just